everyone. Alfred here from Alfred.tv, and it's Wednesday, December 21st, 2011. And what I'm filming for you all now is the second installment of Rap 2011. Come on, let me show you the Gomer's Pile. The pile. Come on.
Well, here's the pile, and I'm definitely a lot more organized than I have been in the past. All the boxes that this shit was shipped in have been, you know, broken down and discarded. But let me show you something special as part of this packing. In my large gray sack that's leaning up against an Arturia Origin synthesizer and a Roland MV8800 workstation. In my large gray sack is crap I'm going to use to pack this shit. Remember, I'm not shipping all of this stuff, just a few things.
So in this installation, you're going to see the shit that I'm shipping up to New York, New Jersey, and Pennsylvania. Is it going to get there on or before Christmas? I say nay, but tough shit. Let's wrap it. Oh, by the way, I got to give you an official Alfred.tv slow pan shot of my shirt. Check it out. Here we go. It's a Walmart special, but the shirt says, "Don't be a Grinch." So there's the official shirt for Rap 2011. Let me show you what's up first for wrapping. For 13-year-old Alexandra, or is it Alexandria? Never freaking remember, but whatever. It's Justin Bieber shit, all right? So we have his new Christmas CD, Under the Mistletoe, all right? And don't get pissed off at the artist, get pissed off at Usher. If you don't like him, blame Usher, because Usher is the one that put him on the map. Usher is the pimp. Justin is the whore in this particular business model. Whatever. And we have Justin Bieber as in his incredible rise to the top. I should edit that where it says rise to the top of Selena Blomez. And Bieber Mania. And here you go. The ultimate collector's edition of Justin Bieber, Never Say Never, which I thought was like a James Bond movie or something like that. And it's the director's fan slut signed by him. But check this out. Look at this. Let me remove the rectal thermometer on this one. It's a freaking Justin Bieber freaking singing toothbrush that sings Baby and You Smile. A Justin Bieber toothbrush. You want to talk about marketing and going a little overboard. Now, let me tell you something very seriously. I actually bought two of them. One for Alexandra, one for me. I'm trying to decide if I should use it as an applicator for my hemorrhoid cream or to clean the grout in the bathroom. You guys can decide. Let's wrap this shit.
So here are the Christmas lights that my friend put up on my balcony out here. And they were actually up on the perimeter, but the lights got a blow job and they fell down. So I just applied some tape, and I don't know if you can see it, but it's just basically like the shape of, like, you know, just like a pair of breasts. No big deal. So those are the Christmas lights on my balcony. Here is the box for the Christmas lights on my balcony. And watch how easy it is to put Justin Bieber in the box. Ruta. Freaking Ruta. Zoop. Zoop. Whatever. Adam B will correct me on the proper Bugs Bunny vernacular. Get down here. Done. Done. And just look at how beautiful and festive that is. To Alexandra from Uncle Alfred, crap to drive your brother's crazy rap. With, of course, industrial packing tape and tape on the bow. Let me tell you why.
Because the bows from Walmart really suck. Moving right along.
For Troy, Call of Duty, Modern Warcraft 3. Just a freaking Modern Warcraft instead of Warfare. Warfare 3. Yeah, whatever. I really get pissed off when people snipe me, so I hope he doesn't do that. And then, you know, and then this game called The Elder Scrolls V5 Skyrim, which I heard is a really great game. But
as many of you know, I was really upset with the death of Steve Jobs. Oh, wow, oh, wow, oh, wow, or whatever the hell he said. So I like to remind people from time to time about Steve Jobs. So, watch.
Definitely has potential now. Nice. And remember, why do I rap the way I rap? To confuse, frustrate, disappoint, and annoy after potentially an upfront thrill. So these two games will be wrapped, and I think this needs to be put on top for the impact. All right, one-handed filming. It didn't. The camera work didn't go too well. I was trying to do this really nice and smooth. There you go. An original iPad box. Nice. Final rap to Troy from Uncle Alfred. A don't freaking snipe me rap. He better not, or I'll throw him off my Xbox Live friends list.
As many of you know, I love shit that like glows in the dark and lights up. And I also like giving such items as gifts. Check this out.
My nephew Mike Mack told me about this product from ThinkGeek. This LED glow-in-the-dark whatever jellyfish with this touchpad so you can modulate the colors, you know? And this thing even got a Red Dot Design Award, though I don't know what the hell has to do with an award session from people from India. But be that as it may, let's wrap this. And there you have it. To Drew from Uncle Alfred, cool stuff that lights up a wrap. But let's do the post-wrap analysis. The post-wrap analysis. And what can I say? But nothing says I care. Nothing says I did this myself more than excessive overhang as well as tears in the wrap job. All right, so from the back, looks like dog shit. From the frontal presentation, not too shabby.
Look, as I may have mentioned before, I do this for you. I post these videos and share my wrapping techniques so we can justify the dog shit wrap jobs, because most normal people can't wrap well. The ones that can wrap really well are typically chicks, or like people that are into, like, you know, the fine arts. All right, come on, who can rap good? Come on, really? I mean, that's it. That's the best I could do. That's it. So this is being posted for you, those warriors that can't rap to save their life.
All right, for my sister Deborah, she likes this Betty Boop crap. And look at how Betty Boop is drawn. I mean, she's a bit of a hoe. But that and Orifice Mac. I got her a new Mac that's already up there. But Orifice and these whatever, 2011, whatever. I can't freaking say whatever. Swarovski. I think that's it. Swarovski? Something like that. I'm just going to throw this in a freaking bag. Look at how beautiful this is. To Deborah from Alfred, a sack of stuff to look like crap under your tree wrap in a Hallmark bag. But there's a sign joke here. That's my older sister. She's 10 years older than me. She's freaking 60 freaking one. Let's edit the bag. As such, we will change gold crown into... Pause the video and tell me what I'm going to make this into. Old crow. Nice.
For my buddy David, the creative one, another jellyfish, but check out the edit.
We're going to change it from touch your color world to touch your left nipple. Nice.
By the way, my friend David, he loves penguins, thus the penguin wrapping paper.
Matter of fact, depending on the time of day, he often clays his penguin. Be that as it may, and moving right along, here's the final wrap. And to David from Alfred, really, touch it wrap. Notice a disgusting puke green bow on there to contrast the red. Am I good with color coordination or what?
For my buddy David's birthday, which is just a few days before Christmas, I thought it would be appropriate to get him like all depressed and whatnot with these.
Special edition publications celebrating Steve Jobs. So this is Fortune Magazine, and this is the one from Time.
Oh my God, he's dead! He's dead, Jim. That was a really crappy impersonation of like McCoy. It sounded more like Spock. Who cares?
Steve Jobs typically thought outside the box. Now, since his death, I thought it would be appropriate to wrap him inside the box. And here we go. A coffin wrap. And we try to do this so we don't damage the publications. And, yeah. All right. Yeah, there it is. And Good night, Steve. And look at how nice. To David from Alfred, coffin wrap opened carefully so as not to damage books. Very inefficient use of space here, though. We have a lot of leftover space, so we're going to make this a multi-wrap and throw a few more items in there. It'll help buffer the contents also.
Now, the next item for David is not really a gift. It's just like more of a tradition. Every year, I enjoy Halloween Horror Nights up at Universal Studios Orlando, and they have a signature shot glass. Let me show you my collection.
Whilst I've been attending for a while, I started collecting the glasses in 2008. So here's the 2008 glass, 2009, 2010, which is really nice. That was their 20th anniversary, and 2011, the 21st anniversary. So the theme is the whole gambling thing. The house always wins. So I got him that glass. Let's wrap it real easy. Oh, I just shoved the freaking thing in a Nioxin scalp treatment box. Gee, I figured these guys would be sponsors. Notice the overhang on a glass item. So, but yeah, whatever. And is that festive or what? I mean, does it get any better? I mean, really? All right, for David's sister, Kristen, I got her this Hilfiger perfume called Tommy Girl. So it's a woman's perfume named Tommy Girl. I assume this has transsexual or lesbian, implications or inferences or whatever, so I'm going to wrap it. And it's supposed to be really good from the reviews on Google, unless they freaking lied.
Look, as with a lot of things that I do, I try to go for consistency where I can. So, with the ladies, what type of wrapping paper?
Wrapping paper that says ho on it really works. And here's the grand finale, wrapped in ho paper, a perfume named Tommy Girl. To Kristen from Alfred, a transgender ho wrap.
Now, Dave Sr., Big Dave, really does enjoy those wholesome family movies like Happy Feet and Polar Express. He watches them with the family, so I always try to expand on his DVD movie collection. Let me show you a movie I'm getting him for this holiday season. I think it's just another holiday classic, really.
Starring Rutger Hauer, the name of the movie is Oboe with Ash. It's about a musician named Ash who plays the oboe, and it's during the holiday season, and he does a lot of good deeds and charity work and gift giving to the family members and whatnot. I really don't understand the graphics on the cover, but whatever. I thought this would be a lovely holiday movie. And for the Wawa Mama Debbie, I'm getting her a crystal. You think I can, show it to you? No! Let me just wrap this thing. I gotta get to the UPS store. Store. Look at this one. Look at this wrap job. Does this set, an entirely new low standard or what? I mean, look at the edge detection on this. I mean, is this incredible? So there you have it. Matter of fact, I don't think you can get much worse than this. But to Debbie from Alfred, one of the worst wraps ever. You know what's funny? Someone planting a bomb. The inside mechanics and pyrotechnics, explosives, chemicals, whatever, of the bomb would probably look better than this. This wrap job, or multi-wrap at this point. To David, Kristen, Dave, and Debbie from Alfred, it's a multi-wrap. Yes, we want to be space efficient. Oh, and for Big Dave, Dave Sr., for his iPad, the Atari Arcade. So now he has, two joysticks he can play with. Nice. Oh, what the hell, I just threw it in a universal bag. To Dave from Alfred, another joystick to play with, wrap. Beautiful. And festive, with Spider-Man. Oh, and there's the final suite of products. Look at that aerial shot. Is this beautiful cinematography or what? Is this stuff gonna look great under the tree? Yeah, if it gets there on time. Heading to the UPS store now. Ah, the UPS store rhymes with... I got to the UPS store. The stuff looks really crappy and it's arriving on Tuesday, so better late than never. Whatever.
Ah, that's some of the worst packaging I've ever seen.
Thanks, Dave.
But wait, there's more. Rhymes with, as a box from UPS arrives. Nice.
I might have put industrial staples up at the top. I usually do stupid things like that. Did I put industrial... Wait, take a look at the wrap. Take a look at the label. What does it say?
It says, to Deborah, from Alfred, a sack of stuff to look like crap under your tree rack.
All right, now wait, Deb, you're missing part of the packaging. Look at the beauty of the packaging. look what it says.
Mark Old Pro?
Yeah, because I covered up the G in gold and the N in crown. Isn't that good?
You call it Old Pro. Hey, knock it off.
Yeah, I'm not too young either anymore.
Knock it off. No, that's right, my baby brother.
Welcome to Alfred Duck TV.